Yeah, see what you can pick up if you get yourself a decent fan.
That's a great bit of play.
Young Philip Edward, 31998.
Right.
Donegal John, 12002.
Okay.
Spadovici Domenico, 11892.
Right.
Desario Joe, 34691.
Okay.
Look at this. I've been sacked.
Matheson Ronald, 46918.
Righto.
Davies Road, 5809.
Okay.
You lousy no good bastard!
Take
why
it
me?
Easy, son.
Get
take
lost,
it
will you?
Take
get out of it! You think you can lay off anyone you like?
Jesus. You're nothing but a troublemaker, Matheson! Yeah. We don't want anyone.
Piss off, will you?
You
I'll go when I'm good and fucking ready to go!
Go on, get on your way!
Fuck off, will you? Bastards! Alright, I'm going, I'm going!
Have a nice holiday.
Hey! Well, give us me bloody bag!
That manifold could help you, mate. See ya.
Broken shift, Mum?
You've been sacked.
I was laid off.
You didn't cause any trouble.
Mum, I was laid off. Production takes a dive, someone's got to suffer. You can bet it won't be the fucking manager either.
Don't swear, Ron.
Yeah, that's it, isn't it? You just have to shut up and take it, bastards. You had a rough day?
I'm back on at 5, and I've got a headache.
Well, take a sickie.
I'd love to, Ron, but I can't afford it, particularly with you off.
I'll get another job. I'll be down at the job centre first thing in the morning, Mum. I'm not going to bludge on you, you know that.
I know, Ron. I know.
Priced at $16,215, our Price Elite $410, the prize of prizes, a car of the future, conserving energy and offering you the ultimate in safety and comfort. The 240D, engineered like no other car. Priced at $29,938, our price only $480. Mercedes-Benz of Australia and the
wait till it's called, please. Next. Your name?
Scott Chapman.
Take a number, wait till it's called. Next.
David Watson.
173.
Take a number, wait till you call, please.
173.
Next, thank you.
Okay. Take a number, wait till you call, please. Next.
Eric Halfby.
Eric Halfby. Who?
That's not what it says on the form.
Take it back, please. Next. What's your name?
Carvel.
Okay, take a number and wait till it's called, please.
Paul O'Flaherty.
Who?
Paul O'Flaherty.
O'Flaherty. Yes, take a number and wait till it's called. Next, please. What's your name?
Harry Michaels.
Michaels, right.
Come in, it's not locked.
It was something they taught us at boarding college, to always knock first before entering. May I?
You Matheson, Ronald Stephen.
At your service, sir.
Why'd you lose your apprenticeship, Ron?
Drive an Alpha, do we?
GTV? Alpha Sud, perhaps?
What is this?
Tell me, don't you find the Alpha too untractable for city driving?
Why did you lose your apprenticeship?
Usual reason. If I'd have got my papers, I'd have stopped being cheap labour, right? So they booted me out and took on another kid. I'll get rid of him before his time, too.
Well, I've got a job for you. Be at the Adelaide Brighton Cement Works, 7 sharp tomorrow.
Cement Works. Look, all you've ever given me in this dump's shovel work.
They want 20 men.
Well, what the hell was I given this for, huh? Might as well trade the useless thing in.
Yes. Yes, I heard about your behaviour at the McElraith Motorworks yesterday afternoon when they told you you were stood down.
Stood? I was sacked. Again. Stop covering for them. They axe anyone when it suits them.
Ron, your services have been found unsatisfactory by 7 employers in 18 months. That is not a good record.
Unsatisfactory? I was last on, first off.
Your record doesn't look good, and you're only making excuses.
Oh, shit, what is this?
Your language, Ron. Employers can afford to be choosy these days. You should tailor your aspirations to the job opportunities as they become available.
Thanks for the job.
I work at McElraith's. Night, I drive a cab. The vehicle you're in is all paid for.
Oh, get off.
Sacrifice didn't need paying for.
Well, listen, how about knocking us off another manifold then, eh?
You know what your trouble is, mate? You don't know how to eat shit. Well, look at me. I do it all the time. That's what the world's about. That's what made this country great. The smiling shit eaters. Of course, it's getting difficult with all them fiat-faced rocks. I mean, they work for nothing, mate. They're grabbing 2 or 3 jobs at a time, some of them. One thing I'll give you bloody ammo, he's not getting an arrow, is he? Hey? I mean, he's taking his pension and nicking off walkabout. In any case, he's a tourist attraction. As for them bloody dull bludgers, mate, let them starve. They won't eat shit, mate, and that's the only way to survive. This man ought to charge you for this quality of advice.
Yeah, look, just here will do. Thanks for the lift.
Like a result. Hey, here, don't forget, you be nice to the man and the man will be nice to you.
Yeah, you keep smiling, Bill, but don't forget to clean your teeth.
Come on, you blokes, line up. Come on, we haven't got all day.
See you later, love.
Quality, price, and availability.
Sorry, mate, it's okay. Here you go. Hey.
Too late, mate.
I got a slip here from the job centre.
You only need 20 or 21.
But I was promised a job.
Well, you weren't promised it by me, and I'm the only one who counts around here.
Look, they told me to get down here by 7 o'clock. It's not even 2:15 yet.
Matheson, Ronald. Don't bother to call back here, Ronald. We don't employ your type.
Well, you can shove your fucking job, you prick. I didn't want it anyway.
Go on, unit. Good work now.
It's a beautiful day in Adelaide. Sun is shining for a change. That's really good.
How would you know? You haven't had the curtains open all morning.
Never mind. Let's get on with the news coming up in just a second.
The Beatles, the days in their life, continues tomorrow, 3 till 6, and presented by Alpine Car Hi-Fi.
How'd you like to get into that particular Model A? You're looking at about 100 grand, eh? Yeah, what can I do?
Could you give me a trade-in price on my MGB?
'68 Model A. Great little performer. Used to run one myself. Of course, the demand's more for the GTB these days. Walk up. Well, we could probably do something with it. What did you have in mind trading for?
This.
Well, I could give you 5 on the B, leaving 6 to pay on the stag.
11? Saw an Alpha GTV at Taylor's the other day.
I know the one. That was Roland repaired.
Yeah?
Of course, you don't want to believe everything you hear. Look, I'll tell you what. We'll go for a spin in this little beauty. Along the way, we can discuss a bit of a deal.
Great.
She's 3 litres, V8, fuel injected, of course, house steering, PBs, handles like a silken nymph. You're used to this sort of machine, I take it?
Oh, yeah. I had a TR3 a few years back.
Oh, classic machine. Classic machine.
Mom, back in about 20 minutes. She's borrowing all her Lancers in for service. Sorry about that.
Got plenty of talk, hasn't she? Made for this kind of traffic, eh? Good as gold.
Steering needs some attention.
Tyres. Probably the tyres. No reason why we couldn't throw in a new set.
Vehicle is fucked.
Oh, you wait.
Hi, Maggie.
Hi.
Oh, God, Mum, not another hairdo.
Did you get the job, Rob? Of
course he did. Mind you, it's only a fill-in till he gets another apprenticeship.
For Christ's sake, Mum, you can't get an apprenticeship when you're 22. Yeah, it looks lovely, Mum.
No, I wouldn't class myself as an adrenaline junkie, but that would be far too dangerous. Once I've completed a stunt like a car roll, there is an incredible energy surge, a build-up of adrenaline, which makes me react very quickly during the stunt. These seconds really expand into almost a minute inside my own mind because everything is going so fast. And yet, when you hear it all happening, it's as terrifying as what you might expect. It's more sitting back and going, wow. Like it's an experience, I know I'm not really going to get hurt, and therefore it's quite an amazing experience. And with the car roll, once that's completed, the fear's gone, and there's just this adrenaline which you don't know.
Been here long?
Oh, about a fucking week.
Max
Brown. Yeah, you heard me. What's this about finding us work, eh? You couldn't find your ass in front of a mirror.
Have a complaint, sir. We've a form for you to follow. Just fill this in. Take it over to that counter.
Look, I don't want to spend the rest of my life in a queue. I want to work, even if you bastards don't.
I have to advise you, sir, speaking like this...
I don't want a job as a newsreader. I just want a job.
Unless you learn to present
yourself. Present myself? Oh, don't talk to me about presenting myself. I've been presenting myself in these bloody queues for the past 5 years. So don't give me any of that shit. You bastards only work here 9 to 5. I fucking live here. Approved!
Thank you.
we've already made towards economic development. The runs are on the board. Inflation is down. Interest rates have cut a curve. Unfortunately, unemployment is still far too high. That's a great concern to me, and I know it's a concern to all of you. If Australians are only prepared to get up and have a go, we can take on the challenge of the 1980s and create the Australia.
If you want $100 this thing, matey, that two-inch system's going with it.
Oh, get lost. The bloody system's worth $100 by itself.
Well, it's worth fuck all without it. There's no carby. Where's the carby?
Oh, for Christ's sake.
Just bought this, have you?
Yeah. Today.
Yeah? Would you pay more than $100 for it?
Okay, $100 for the lot. Just get it out of here.
Sunshine. You want to say anything? You're up.
Firm quote on renewing that old lounge suite. All you got to do is to ring them on 461352, and all you have to do is to ring me on 267-1111. It's good morning.
Good morning. Well, I'm ringing up. I've got a son who just can't get work, and I just don't know what to do about it. And he's a real good lad. He's not a rat lad. He doesn't been around the streets or anything. My husband and I, we both tried and keep his spirits up. But as I said, him loving animals as he does, I mean, it's a hard deal to get into, but I thought, you know, that might be a good idea.
Is transport a problem? Can he literally go anywhere to try for a job? What sort of areas?
Well, I mean, transport, no, not really. Because I've got a car and I'd be quite willing if it was, you know, a long way.
Do you want a lift somewhere?
Yeah. My car's in for service. Alpha GTV. You know the Martins?
Yes.
They're my parents.
Annie?
Ronald Matheson, the scourge of Mansfield Park High School.
Oh, shit. You knew it was me all along, didn't you? Where the hell have you been?
Oh, driving around for the past 2 days trying to work up the courage to go back home.
No, God, no. I mean, since you left.
What? Cruising.
You seem to have come a long way since then. Why'd you come back?
Why not? Now, where can I drop you?
Import Motors. I've got to pick up my car, Annie.
You haven't changed a bit, Ron. You're still full of shit.
Listen, Annie, we've got to get together again sometime.
Why?
Just for fun. Besides, I've got your number. What time?
Any time before 5.
What happens after 5?
Come early. We'll go for a drive. In your Alpha.
Can I be of any assistance, sir?
Do you have any jobs for a detailer?
Piss off, son.
Say, I'm afraid we have no situations for a man of your capabilities, sir. Say it.
I'm afraid we have no situations for a man of your capabilities. Sir.
Thanks anyway.
Yes.
Man, I've been trying to get you for hours. How are your parents?
Okay.
Not good, eh?
Look, I don't want to talk about it. She called me a whore. My mother did.
That's ridiculous.
We sleep together. You pay my rent. What the hell else does that make me?
I need more than that. Can't you see?
Please come over here.
Well, in other words, I am just here at your convenience. I'll go for a drive instead, in your Porsche. Well, no, Bill. Someone else. A bigger liar than you are. I might even screw the kid stupid. You better hurry over here if you want to find me. I left him with his tongue hanging out. Billy mightn't be in your class, but at least he's around. Yes. Well,
that's
up, will you? Righto. Standard, son. It's turbocharged. Nice set of wheels. Yes, adequate for my purposes, I find. Look, when you're finished with that, would you be so kind as to check the oil and park it over there for me?
Yeah, sure.
Taken. Which way are you headed? I'm driving to Sydney if you need a lift.
Can you go to Sudan?
Why not?
That's where I'm going.
Right.
All fixed up, sir. That'll be 15.
I'll pay when I've eaten. Did you do the windscreen?
Of course.
Good. Thanks. Hey, is that good?
I wouldn't be eating it if it wasn't.
Yeah, one of those. Would you like another coffee?
Okay.
Yeah, and two coffees, thanks.
So one hamburger lot, two coffees.
Yeah, listen, what's the lot?
A seg, bacon, beetroot, pickles, tomato, onion with truckers, taco sauce.
Great, but no beetroot.
You're already made.
I hate beetroot.
Hi, I'm Sally.
Ron.
It's all on the one bill?
Yeah, all except the beetroot.
I'll pay for mine.
All together, thank you.
I don't want to pay for my own.
It's on my expense account. I'm not paying, so why should you?
Okay. I'll go clean myself up then.
You! The bill.
Oh, sorry.
$3.50.
Too many things on my mind. Thank you.
paid inside. Here's the change.
Thanks. Thanks a lot. Hey, how'd you know how much it was?
You like it?
I'm running away. That's what I'm doing.
I ran away once. When I was a kid. I was at boarding college in the country.
What happened?
Nothing. Not a thing. I just got bored, so I went back.
What did they do to you?
Who are you, the FBI or something?
Look, I didn't ask for the story. You began it.
You know, when I'm in this car, I sort of remember what it was like running away.
Yeah, you'd really suffer. Running away from Mummy and Daddy in this.
It cost me plenty.
Her money, his stocks and shares. Cost you.
You bastards, move over.
If you're an agent.
God, what are you on about? What kind of an agent?
That depends on the assignment.
Sounds dangerous. Ask me to spend the night in a motel.
I'm not.
Come on, I was only kidding. I don't mind.
I'm going to ask you to spend the night in a pine forest with me. Well, it's supposed to be very romantic.
Hope you've got an air mattress.
You see, I'm really a very eccentric millionaire.
I thought maybe if I kissed you, you'd turn into a frog.
Do you know that I could take you anywhere you like? To Sydney? The Gold Coast? Anywhere?
I just want to get to Sudan.
Look, what the hell is so important about Sudan?
My baby. I want to get my baby back.
Jesus Christ.
You see, the welfare people took him away from me. The old hag next door reckoned I was an unfit mother.
Okay. We'll go to Sudan.
Okay.
How old is he?
18 months.
What's his name?
Adam.
What color hair?
Blonde. Early this morning. Is it the cops?
We could have been killed, and all you're worried about is a damn turnoff.
Jesus. It's just a game we played. He just wanted a race.
He saw you. Well, even terrorists don't like to wipe out young mothers.
Yeah,
sure. What is this place?
Home. You wait here, okay? I'll only be a minute.
Not that it matters.
Suit you. Yeah.
Hi.
We'll be off then, Jenny.
It's good looking, isn't he? Better than pig face.
Oh, shut up, you bitch.
I'll tell him you dropped in then.
You say nothing, you hear? I don't want that bastard anywhere near me and the kid.
Oh, do yourself a favour, Sal. Forget the kid.
Come on.
Hey, film star. Don't let it near the kid, okay? She's better off without it.
Oh, shit, they've scratched it.
Get in the car.
Hey! You saw them do it!
Get in the car, come on.
Yeah, you saw them, didn't you? Break their bloody little necks, I will.
Come on, Ron, please.
Look, Sally, what the hell is going on? Who was that in there?
My sister. Come on, we've got to do some shopping.
Shopping? We haven't got any money.
Ron, let's get out of here, please.
Got to get a few things straight.
Look, it's all right. We need food. We need baby food and nappies
baby
and...
Baby food?
Listen, Ron, anyone who can take on motorcycle terrorists single-handed could steal a little baby food. My baby was fostered out to these farmers who live out here somewhere.
Who's Pigface?
The father.
Did you have the kid back there?
Yeah.
Well, what about your parents? Where are they?
Who cares? I don't know, drunk somewhere. You're going to start getting heavy on me too. You know, they want women to have kids in this country. They're crying out for kids. And then what happens? They take him away. Stupid bitch next door always staring, calling the cops and the welfare. Sterile old hag.
Hey, Sally, I'm on your side. I said we'll get the kid. Then it's back to my trip, all right?
You know somewhere we could go?
We'll find somewhere.
Further information on the Porsche involved in a 203 last evening. Driver's believed to be a Ronald Matheson, who is in company with a Sally Wallace, a 16-year-old absconder from the St. Agnes Training Centre. Delta 2-1 to investigate. Delta 2-1.
Roger, control.
Tomorrow. We'll get him tomorrow.
Maybe we can get him tonight.
We have to plan it out. We've got to wait till her husband's out of the house.
I want him. I just want to hold him.
Look, I know. Don't worry. We'll get him. I promise.
You stole the car, didn't you?
I told you, it's my cover.
Sally? Sally?
Oh.
Excuse me?
What do you want?
We camped up the road and could I buy some milk?
Yeah, of course. Do you want to come inside?
Thanks. Baby.
He's a little devil. Have you got anything for the milk?
No, can we borrow something?
Yeah, I suppose.
He's not actually our child, you see. We're just fostering him.
Be quiet.
His mother used to bash him. That's why he's a bit scared of people sometimes.
It's not true.
Shh. I've got an old plastic jug. Will that do?
Please be quiet, please.
Sally!
Who are you?
Come on, they're on to us. Quick, leave him. Sally!
Run!
Let go!
Run! Give me the baby! No, I want you! Give me the baby!
Sally,
give me
the baby!
Delta 11, we're under the mangrove.
about Adam?
Look, let's get out of this mess first, then we'll worry about Adam.
Really blew it, didn't I?
Jesus. How come James Bond never runs out of petrol?
Keep driving, we'll find petrol. Come on, we'll find it, okay?
Hey, we need petrol.
You're on the radio, you know.
Oh, come on, get moving.
Hey, wait a minute.
Hurry up,
will you? All right. I've got a hand pump it, you know.
We'll start pumping then.
Hey, it's them, Bonnie and Clyde.
Would you like a cup of tea while you wait?
Oh, some sandwiches would be nice, thanks.
You know you haven't got bucklers, don't you, son?
Hey, is there another way out of here?
Through the gate, follow along the fence, and you come to the road to the coast. You got a submarine to catch? Mm. There's a nice little jalopy. Must have cost a bit, eh?
Ron, look what they gave us.
Just get in the car, Sally.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Come on.
There's no need to be so rude. I don't understand you. We could have hit back there. We could have been safe.
Well, you can always get out and walk back if you want.
Well, we can't keep on driving forever.
Have you got any better ideas?
You can dump the car. That's what they're looking for.
I'm not going to dump the car, so just get off my back, will you? I know what I'm doing, okay?
Okay, okay. Why don't we at least get off the road for a while?
All right.
Guess what?
Beats pine needles?
Yeah.
afternoon. A young police constable was in a critical condition in the Royal Adelaide Hospital after being run down by a luxury sports roadster at Cowan's Creek earlier today. Major Crime Squad Director Ben Rawson says police are anxious to discuss the incident with the couple Ronald Matheson and Sally Wallace.
I just couldn't.
Matheson's wanted in connection with numerous offences since
allegedly
stealing
a
silver-coloured Porsche from the city 2 days ago.
I can't go back and change it.
Spotted in the Sudan area, where they're believed to have held up an elderly couple on a farm before escaping with petrol and other...
They're out there, aren't they?
The injured constable's name hasn't been released yet.
They're out there just waiting for us.
Well, why don't you come and get us then?
Ron, come here, please. Look, it'll be better in the morning, you'll see. We'll find a way out.
There you go, mate. Thanks, mate. Hey, what about the milk?
Thank you.
Where are you heading?
I don't know. As far as you can take me. There's a friend of mine a couple of miles ahead. Can we pick her up?
Sure, plenty of room.